Hello everyone, welcome or welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time watching my video, then let me give you a quick introduction. I'm Aishwarya. I usually upload videos on this channel based on medical lectures, health tips, study vlogs and many more things. So don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell. The topic of today's video is going to be nephritic and nephrotic syndrome. We will understand them in detail and compare them. So without much delay, let's jump into the topic. Nephritic syndrome and nephrotic syndrome. Let's understand the nephritic syndrome. Nephritic syndrome is inflammation. Whenever there is inflammation of glomerulus, nephritic syndrome is seen. I hope you guys remember this. If you don't remember, you can check out in the list description box. I will link the video of the structure of nephron and all the functions, physiology of a nephron and kidney. It will be easy for you all if you have seen that earlier. So whenever there is inflammation of glomerulus, what happens is this basement membrane becomes permeable to particular things that will lead to leaking of the RBCs. In normal physiology, this doesn't happen, but due to excessive permeability, that will lead to leaking of RBCs and some amount of protein as well. When it comes to nephrotic syndrome, here there is no inflammation, but there is some changes in the glomerulus itself. Whenever the glomerulus is there, there is changes seen in the cells of the glomerulus, and that will lead to leaking of massive proteins. Now, whenever there is changes in that glomerulus, what will happen is the permeability is increased, and that will lead to leaking of massive proteins. So whenever there is inflammation, that is nephritic syndrome. Whenever there is changes in the glomerular cells itself, that is nephrotic syndrome. Remember, with the eye, there are two eyes in the nephritic syndrome. So that is inflammation, and there is O here, which will lead to proteinuria. Remember this massive proteins leakage. So remember this with this synonym. It is easy for you guys to remember. Now next we come to the causes. What are the causes of our nephritic syndrome? The causes are such as post-streptococcal infection, especially in children. Usually get this post-streptococcal infection, that is throat infection and all. If it is not treated, what the immune system usually does is it creates the antigen-antibody complexes. So these antigen-antibody complexes, these actually not the bacteria itself, but these antigen-antibody complexes, they inflame the glomerulus, that leading to nephritic syndrome. Some of the other causes are IgA nephropathy and others such as polyarteritis nodosa, cryoglobulinemia and some of these. When it comes to the nephrotic syndrome causes, mainly there is changes in the glomerulus. So we really don't know what is the main cause for these changes. So the first thing is idiopathic, it is unknown. And we can see minimal change disease usually seen in pediatrics and some other diseases, general systemic disease such as lupus, diabetes mellitus, heart failure, etc. and hypersensitive reactions. So these are some of the outline of the causes of the nephritic and nephrotic syndrome. Now let's understand the nephritic syndrome first. Nephritic syndrome. The nephritic syndrome is characterized by the presence of hematuria. Hematuria is nothing but red blood cells, that is erythrocytes, in the urine, and mild proteinuria, that is protein in the urine. HTN, that means hypertension. There is edema and oliguria and reduced declining or renal function. So nephritic syndrome represents if there is hematuria, mild proteinuria, hypertension, edema, oliguria and reduced or declining renal function. Now hematuria, it is slightly smoky appearance of urine. In hematuria is nothing but you can see the smoky appearance of urine with mainly the presence of erythrocytes, which is usually microscopically. Next is proteinuria, where in nephritic syndrome the proteinuria is mild and non-selective. Like whereas in nephrotic there is selective proteinuria mainly. I will discuss it when we'll be dealing with nephrotic. Hypertension is also mild. Edema is mild, and here in nephritic syndrome edema is mainly because of sodium and water retention. Because of sodium and water retention, edema is seen in nephritic syndrome. Next is the oliguria. It depends. Now this oliguria in nephritic syndrome depends upon the involvement of the glomerulus. How much inflammation has taken place, it depends on that. So this is about the nephritic syndrome. Now we come to our next syndrome, that is the nephrotic syndrome. Nephrotic syndrome, it is characterized by massive proteinuria. This is the main thing in nephrotic syndrome. There is hypoalbuminemia, there is edema, there is hyperlipidemia, there is lipiduria, and hypercoagulability. Now proteinuria. Here proteinuria is highly selective proteinuria, means protein in the urine is mainly the low molecular weight proteins. The proteins in our body which are low molecular weight, those are excreted more. So that is mainly low molecular weight proteins are nothing but the albumin. So albuminuria is mainly seen in nephrotic syndrome. Hypoalbuminemia means there is reduced albumin in our body fluid, that is our blood and in our body. So it is very simple to understand. It is due to urinary loss of albumin. Due to selective proteinuria, there is loss of albumin. So excessive loss of albumin will lead to reduced albumin in our body. So that is nothing but hypoalbuminemia. And also due to increased renal catabolism and inadequate synthesis of albumin. In hypoalbuminemia, 1 to 3 gram per dl is seen, and even the albumin and globulin ratio is reversed in our body. The next is the edema. Edema, it is due to fall in colloidal osmotic pressure consequent upon hypoalbuminemia. Due to hypoalbuminemia, reduced protein, there is disturbance or fall in colloidal osmotic pressure. Now due to this disturbance, it will lead to edema. Nephrotic syndrome edema is usually peripheral, whereas in children it is usually seen as facial also. There is hyperlipidemia. Hyperlipidemia is nothing but excessive of lipids in our body. This is because our liver has a lot of pressure of creating albumin. Now this also simultaneously, it also increases the production of lipids. So due to this stress of albumin synthesis, it simultaneously even lipids are synthesized, hence that will lead to excessive lipid in our body. Next is lipiduria. Due to leakage of the basement membrane, it will also leads to hyperlipidemia, following hyperlipidemia, it is seen in urine. The body tries to excrete excessive lipids, leading to Now, here we'll just have a glance of what all we can see in nephritic and nephrotic syndrome. Just a revision for us. Proteinuria in nephritic, inflammation is there. Hematuria is more. So, here the proteinuria is mild. Whereas nephrotic O, if you remember, it is all about the protein O. So, there is heavy proteinuria. Nephritic, it is less than 3 gram per 24 hours, but here it is more than 3 gram per 24 hours. Hyperalbuminemia, we know here due to selective, proteinuria, there is presence of albumin, excessive albumin excretion takes place, whereas here there is nothing particular like that. Mechanism of edema. Now, here in nephrotic syndrome, edema is mild, but mainly it is due to sodium and water retention. Here, edema is marked, and it is mainly due to decreased plasma osmotic pressure and to some extent sodium and water retention as well. Hematuria, remembering inflammation, hematuria, yeah, hematuria is present and it is microscopic. Here it is absent. Hypertension, mainly seen in nephritic syndrome, but here also it is seen in very advanced cases. Hyperlipidemia is absent in nephritic syndrome. It is present in nephrotic syndrome. Oliguria is present in nephritic. It is advanced, present in advanced diseases in nephrotic. Whereas hypercoagulability is absent in nephritic syndrome and it is present in nephrotic syndrome. This was all about nephritic and nephrotic syndrome. Thank you for watching the video. If you liked this video or if you found this video helpful, make sure you comment and let me know. Thank you.